curiosity and wonder. Let's discover together. It's Science Wow.
I'm about to take you on a virtual field trip where the regular public can't usually go. Behind the scenes at the DIA. Let's go check it out. We're meeting with Kathy Sylvius-DeRue. She's a research scientist at the DIA.
Oh. Hi, are you Hi. Morgan?
Yeah.
Oh, come on in. This is a sculpture of St. Francis, and we have questions about the history of the painted surface. This sculpture is about 400 years old, and we're interested to find out the pigments that were used to paint the surface of this sculpture.
What do you mean by pigments?
Pigments are the colorants that are used to create a painting. The color you see on this sculpture. 400 years ago, most pigments that were used by artists were from the earth. They were mineral-based that were ground up to a very fine powder and then mixed with some sort of binding medium and then painted on the surface of St. Francis or even on a painting.
Now, why are we looking at the pigments?
Well, we have questions about the surface on St. Francis. This is paint over wood. We know that he's a wooden sculpture. And we're wondering if the painted surface that we see today is the original surface or not. The workhorse instrument is an instrument known as an X-ray fluorescence spectrometer. We typically refer to it as XRF.
XRF, remember that.
X-ray fluorescence spectrometer.
Okay.
And what it does is it gives us information about the elements in a material. And by elements I mean, is there iron in this pigment? Is there copper in this pigment? Understanding the elements present helps you figure out what pigments could likely be present. It is totally non-destructive. The technique, nothing touches the object.
Okay.
We just fire a very narrowly focused X-ray beam at the surface of the object.
How about we check out an XRF spectrum?
The X-rays will come out this little red-tipped orifice here. This is a video-guided system. And the X-ray beams will hit exactly where crosshairs and the laser pointer intersect.
She tries to align the laser and the crosshairs together so she can get that perfect, perfect point.
So I'm there.
She did it.
Okay.
So this graph is showing us what elements are present in the paint. So how many times do you do this? Can you tell us?
In the case of this particular sculpture, I took more than 20 spectra from various locations on the sculpture of St. Francis. We're looking at St. Francis's knuckle.
Okay.
And we're trying to figure out which pigments are present. And when I see this sort of pattern here, they indicate the presence of lead, but then there's this one here. They're very close to the lead peaks, but they're very distinctive and indicate the presence of mercury. You know, this is primarily lead white with the presence of mercury to give it that pinkish hue. And
okay.
The mercury red, the mercuric sulfide red, that would have been mixed with lead white to create the pink surface of his knuckle. So if we go back into the XRF room and we pull St. Francis away, have another look at the knuckle.
Okay.
And you will see that
there's
it's pink.
So what did you ultimately learn from all the research you did on St. Francis?
What we learned that the painted surface that you see on St. Francis right now is not the original surface. That the painted surface that you see now was applied sometime around the late 18th century or later.
So Kathy, what subjects somebody have to study to do what you do?
Chemistry, physics, biology, geology,
and that's pretty much all the science, right?
All of the sciences. Okay. All of the sciences influence conservation science, and then it helps to have a ferocious curiosity too.
Okay.
So now take a look at that knuckle. Yeah. What do you see?
Pink. Mercury. It's pink.
Yeah, so you have the mercury sulfide red mixed with the lead white to give that pinkish flesh tone.
Thank you so much, Kathy.